students, welcome to Science Fair. In this period, we are going to learn about plant reproduction. In this period, we are going to learn about next topic of plant reproduction. So, let's start a new topic, seed dispersal. So, what is the seed dispersal? The movement of the seeds from one place to another place, that is called the dispersion of the seeds. So, we have to study about the dispersion of the seeds and the way of dispersal of seeds. How do seeds disperse? Seeds disperse by the four medium. First is wind, animal, explosion and water. So, let's go and start our topic, seed dispersal.
So, flowering plants have different adaptations to enable the seeds to be dispersed as far away as possible. Some methods of seeds dispersal are dispersal by wind, dispersal by water, dispersal by explosion and dispersal by animals. So first, dispersal by wind. Many seeds are carried away by the wind. The seeds of dandelion, desert rose and the milkweed are like the parachutes. The wing seeds of Indian elm tree glide in the wind. The wind carries such weeds away from the mother plant. Some of these seeds fall on the ground and get covered with the soil and germinate when it rains. Second one, dispersal by animals. Many kinds of ripe fruits are eaten by birds, squirrels and bats. These animals often take a fruit to far away places. Most seeds eaten by animals come out in their droppings undigested. People also help in the spreading seeds far away from where they grow naturally. So some animals help in dispersing the seeds. So the hooked spines of certain seeds stick to the feathers of birds and their hairs on the animals and reach far away the places. We know that seeds need to get from where they are formed to the ground to grow into a new plant. The dried fruit explodes, spreading the seeds away from the mother plant. For example, ladyfinger and peas. In this, seeds are violently ejected from the plants so that they fall away from the parent plant. These are the next type of explosion. Next one, dispersal by water. Seeds of some plants that grow in or near water bodies, which are carried by water to different places. For example, coconut. It may drift for several months in the sea before reaching the land. Seed of a water plant such as hydrilla, lotus and water lily are light and spongy. Therefore, they float on the water and carry it to far away places by floating water. Now, next topic is new plants from roots, stem and leaves. All kinds of plants do not grow from seeds. In some cases, new plants are formed from the roots, stem or leaves. This is known as vegetative reproduction. Now first, plants from roots. Some plants form new plants from their roots. For example, sweet potato, breadfruit and the blackberry are some such plants in that they grow from the roots. Second one, plants from stem. Tea, sugarcane, drumstick, mint, rose, jasmine, grape and most of the plants can be grown from stem cutting. Lilies forms bulbs. The bulbs grows into the plants. Sometimes some stems like banana, ginger, turmeric and potato, they develop from the stems. Tiny birds developed on the potato in a certain season. These birds, if buried into suitable soil, it develop into new plants. And last one, plants from leaves. Bryophyllum and sweet potato, they are the plant which are developed from the leaves. थैंक यू, हैव अ नाइस डे.